You're watching season 2 of K-WOW.
Korean word of the week.
Resurrected. Revamped.
And culturefied.
Episode number
74.
74.
74.
74.
Happy K-WOW Wednesday. I'm your main host, Professor O. A lot of people ask me, what do K-pop stars eat? Can you teach us about the Korean diet trends?
And viewers ask me, Miss Billie Jin, how do you stay so thin? Can you please tell us about your eating and workout routine? I sure can. Keep watching to find out.
In honor of health and the new year, Billie Jin and I will be teaching you about the Korean celebrity diets. Granny Kim will also share some of her wisdom. Ready or not, let's get nutritious. But before we take off, diet in Korean is 다이어트. 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 Keep in mind that there are two general types of dieting, short-term and long-term. Short-term diets are focused on rapid weight loss and are usually extreme. Celebrities go on these short-term diets to lose weight quickly for an important event. Long-term diets, on the other hand, are an everyday lifestyle, hopefully one that is healthy and well-balanced. Both short-term and long-term diets are paired with exercise routines, ranging from mild to rigorous. Some K-pop stars claim to eat whatever they want and still look fit. But you can't eat 10 bowls of pasta and expect to look like Girls' Generation and 21. You could be born with the right genes, but celebrities are human too. And not all of them are gonna be born with the perfect genes. Some K-pop stars were actually very chubby before their debut. It takes work to look good and be healthy. Now let's learn about those diets.
The nine muses are said to follow a paper cup diet, where members are limited to eating food that will fit in three paper cups. One cup is filled with fruit, the second cup is filled with either brown rice or mixed grain rice. The third cup is filled with banchan, Korean side dishes. The members eat three meals a day and exercise regularly.
While portion is an important part of dieting, it's not the most accurate measure of quality. If you eat a cup of sweet potatoes, you'll stay full longer and have more energy than eating a cup of lettuce. And the more you exercise, the more you're burning calories, which means you need more food. You can't drive a car without gas in the tank, can you? And depending on how much you drive, some days you'll need a lot more gas than other days.
Nicole from Kara once went on a 13-day Danish diet, where you eat 600 calories a day. The diet consists mainly of lean beef, eggs, coffee, and lettuce. Fruits and grains are traditionally not allowed, though for some reason Nicole ate bananas and grapefruits during her diet. The Danish diet is high protein and low calorie, promising to help you lose 10 to 20 pounds.
Your body can get sick if you change your diet suddenly. Beef and coffee may sound delicious, but did you know they can weaken your bones? That's right, animal protein and caffeine pull calcium from your bone mass. And contrary to popular belief, milk and dairy products also weaken your bones. Milk itself contains calcium. However, upon their childhood, most human beings stop producing the enzymes that break down lactose.
Veggies, on the other hand, build your bones. That's why I could dance like a 21-year-old and not have any wrinkles. So dear children and adults, eat your broccoli, kale, and spinach. I practice what I preach.
Some people practice the blood type diet. They say those with blood type A should only eat vegetables and no meat. To learn more about the blood type diet, watch K-WOW episode 62. In that episode, you'll also learn how different blood types have different personalities.
While the blood type diet seems logical and believable, there's no scientific evidence that says eating for a blood type is actually healthier.
Have you ever heard of the term one food diet? One food diets are geared towards losing a lot of weight real quickly by eating one kind of food a lot. For example, the watermelon diet. Celebrities such as Park Bom used to eat a lot of watermelons to keep the weight off.
Watermelons are very filling and contain little calories. And when you eat less calories, you lose weight. After all, watermelons contain over 90% water. And water helps you lose weight because it makes you feel full without any calories. But remember, drinking too much water is not good for you. Everything must be done in moderation.
There's also the banana diet, which Seohyun Young is famous for following. You can eat as many bananas as you want for breakfast, and for the rest of the day, you can eat whatever you want. Exercise if and when you want.
Just like watermelons, bananas make you feel full without eating too many calories. Make sure you eat ripened bananas. While brown bananas promote bowel movement, green bananas can make you constipated. Brown bananas also taste sweeter. The next time you crave a snack, Grab a banana instead of those greasy potato chips.
If you eat too much, too often of any food, you could develop allergies. Blame your genes, not just your indulgence. To be on the safe and healthy side, just enjoy your favorite foods in moderation.
Many K-pop bands, such as 4MINUTE, Girls' Generation, and A-Pink, incorporate sweet potatoes into their diet, especially before they release a new album and go on comeback performances.
Much like watermelons and bananas, sweet potatoes are very filling. Sweet potatoes are gifts from heaven. They not only taste delicious, but they're also very good for your skin because of their abundance in antioxidants and anti-inflammatory properties.
Make sure you get the organic sweet potatoes. Organically grown food is much more cleaner than the conventional kind. You don't want to eat chemical fertilizers and pesticides, do you? Did you say yes? You nasty.
Ever wonder what Girls' Generation eat to look so thin and yet have energy to dance? It's said that their diet is made up of carefully measured amounts of seasonal vegetables, chicken breast, brown rice, sweet potatoes, eggs, broccoli, and cabbage. Though Seung's sisters say the ladies eat a lot more than what is reported. Some members claim they eat 3,000 calories per meal. But they probably dance it all off.
Time to answer your questions on what Billie Jean and I eat. First off, we never starve ourselves. I get dangerously crabby when I get hungry. For breakfast, I drink warm lemon water, then eat a bowl of fruit. For lunch, I have an organic spinach kale banana smoothie and a bowl of chopped bell peppers, cucumbers, avocados, and heirloom tomatoes. For dinner, I ate a bowl of pea shoots, microgreens, mushrooms, and soaked almonds, drizzled with olive oil. Some nights I'll have steamed sweet potatoes, yams, or pumpkins. Other nights I'll have steamed wild salmon with broccoli, cauliflower, and carrots. I rarely eat red meat, white rice, and any other simple carbs. I also don't drink alcohol unless it's someone's birthday. My favorite workouts include yoga, dancing, and hiking. Back when I used to eat meat and carbs, I battled with acne and felt sleepy all the time. Once I started eating fruits and vegetables, I rarely get pimples, and I also have more energy. If you want to learn more about health and dieting, go check out my alter ego, Ramona Champion. Request diet information on her YouTube channel and follow her on Instagram to see her food and party photos.
By the way, what did you eat today? Let me know in the comment section below.
Have yourselves a K-Wow-rific week. I'll see you guys on Friday, Monday, and Wednesday. 안녕!
Inside of the flap, it has an elephant. What the random?
K-Town, curious what goats do taste like? Or maybe you'd rather have samgyetang. Don't develop bad habits for other people. Are they gonna pay your bills when you get sick? No. It's